This video is based on economic load dispatch problem in power system, and we will try to solve this problem using lambda iteration method. As you can see here, this is the final output for the numerical example that we will solve in this video. Here we have 3 units, and for the 3 units we computed the minimum power and fuel cost. As you can see here, for the first unit, minimum power and cost, that is the fuel cost, for the second unit and for the third unit. Topics covered in this video: first, we have basic introduction about power system, power plants, load center, what is economic dispatch problem, basic quality and inequality constraint used in this problem, what is the aim and how we can solve this problem step by step using numerical example. As we all know that this is also known as economic scheduling. Here power plants are used to generate energy, or you can say electricity. Here we have a turbine that is a prime mover and a generator that we can use to generate the electricity. Here the problem is electric power stations are usually located away from the load center, and power system is divided into 3 parts: power generation, power distribution and power transmission. So we can generate power, distribute and transmission. Here we have certain requirements for the power system: cost of purchasing electricity, employee cost, fuel cost, material cost and other expenses. Among all, the largest cost is fuel cost. As we know, in thermal power plants, they are managed thermal generator, and as we all know, generators are fueled with gas, coal, steam and other. And here in this problem, we have input fuel and output is power generated by the generator. Here we will compute the fuel in dollar per hour, and the power generated by generator is in megawatt. Our aim is here to achieve the optimum power and minimum fuel cost. As we all know how electricity is generated in thermal power plants, we require some certain amount of fuel, and as we all know that cost of different fuel increasing, so we need here minimum fuel cost. So we have to find out the best decision variable for dispatching problem, dispatching power with lower cost and more reliability. As you can see here, we have widely used input output characteristics. Using this equation, we can calculate the fuel cost. Here you can see we have 3 input output characteristics constant, and you can see this is the equality constraint. Here this is the power generated, power load on the system, and this is the power loss on transmission. This is the inequality constraint that we need to satisfy. Here this is the power generated, and the value that you will compute for the power should satisfy this inequality constraint. As you can see here, this is the minimum power generated and maximum power generated. So the value that we will compute for this should satisfy this inequality constraint. In economic load dispatch problem, we have to determine the amount of power that must be supplied from each generation unit. Here we will determine the minimum cost of our generation. We can use certain meta heuristic algorithms that are inspired by nature. For example, here you can see particle swarm optimization algorithm is one of the most famous meta heuristic algorithm that we can apply to solve economic load dispatch problem. And we have another algorithms as cuckoo search, harmonic search, differential evaluation, artificial bee colony, genetic algorithm, and many more algorithms we can use to solve economic load dispatch problem. That in another video we will discuss how we can solve economic load dispatch problem using meta heuristic algorithm step by step in numerical example. And so in this video we will learn how we can solve economic load dispatch problem using lambda iteration method. Suppose we have, so our aim is here to find out the optimal dispatch and total cost. Here fuel cost is the total cost that we will compute. So suppose total load we have 600, and the value for the 3 unit alpha, beta, gamma you can see here, And now we will assume the value for the lambda. Here, value for the lambda is maximum value in beta. So you can see here, maximum value in beta is this one, that is 38.30553. So this is the value for the lambda. Now you can see we have the inequality constraint here that we need to satisfy. So minimum values you can see here, and the maximum value. So we need to calculate the power. So for the first iteration, we will check this condition here. Value for this is 600, that is power demand. You can see here total load. So this condition is true. Move to next step. Calculate the value for P. Using this equation, we can calculate the value for P. Check minimum, minimum, maximum value. Now calculate the value for the PD, that is total load minus sum of P. Here we will use summation, that is sum of all values for the P, and we got the value for PD is 310. After that, we will calculate the value for lambda. Here we got the new value for the lambda, here this one. Now for the second iteration, check this condition. As you can see, we got the value for PD now 310. Put this value here, condition is true. Move to the next step, put all the values here, and you can see we got the new value for the P, minimum, maximum. And after that, put the value here, and we got the new value for PD is here, 242.3108. After that, calculate the new value for the lambda, put all the values here, and we got the new value for lambda is this one. Now for the third iteration, put the value here, and you can see condition is again true. Now calculate the value for P, minimum, maximum, and now calculate the value for the load, and we got the value this one. Now calculate the value for the lambda. So this is the new value that we computed for the lambda. Now for the fourth iteration, when we will try to check this condition, condition is false, so stop here. So we will exit while loop. Now next, we will calculate the cost. Here, in order to calculate the cost, we will use this equation. So put all the values here, alpha, beta, P here, and we got the value for cost. You can see here this one, so multiply here, and we got total cost, that is summation of cost. And we got total cost, this one. Now you can see here for the three units, we got the power and cost. As you can see here, we have minimum value, maximum value. For the first unit, we have minimum value 35, maximum value 210. And you can see we got the value for the power is in between 35 and 210. For the second unit, you can see the value here is in between 130 and 325. As you can see, this value is in between this. So this value also satisfies this inequality constraint. Now for the third unit, you can see we got 235, and you can see this value is in between 125 and 315. So that's all about this video. Next video, we will try to understand how we can solve economic load dispatch problem using a meta heuristic algorithm step by step with numerical example. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.